Drawing optimization tools are used in BricsCAD to display, store, and use data in the most optimal form, and hence can be used to reduce the file size and save manual work. It can be used in 2D and 3D. This video primarily deals with optimized 2D. Sometimes you get inaccurate drawings as a result of raster to vector conversion through scanning from point clouds, as well as by manually tracing over the drawing of an image. We will see this command with a typical application. Let's insert the image file of a floor plan using the Attach Image option in the Insert tab. I'll click on Attach Raster Image and I'll select this image, open, and you will get the Attach Raster Image dialog box. I'll give OK and I'll insert it over here. Next, I'll create a drawing of the space by tracing the lines over the existing lines in the image. I'll create lines using the line command in the Home tab, and I'll pick a number of points in the image to trace this profile, and I'll come back to this point and give a pick. Next, I'll create the diagonal lines by picking points. After the required profile is traced, you can erase the image. This figure is created in a similar manner, and here you can see a number of lines, and some of the lines are straight and some of the lines are skewed, and you can also see gaps between the lines. Optimize tool closes the gap between the lines and it straightens the skewed lines, and can be used on lines, polylines, and arcs. You can invoke this command either by inputting optimize using the keyboard, or you can activate the Manage tab and you can click on Optimize tool in the Drawing Optimizations panel. I'll click on Optimize. Now the software selects all the entities that can be optimized, and those entities are displayed in blue color, and we get an optimize command panel which will remain active during the lifetime of this command. Optimize command rectifies the line segments to align with the coordinate system axis and connect gaps between the line and arc segments in 2D, or it rectifies the faces to align with the coordinate system plane in 3D. As you can see here, there are two modes, 2D and 3D. Both these modes are disabled because it works in 2D mode and there is no 3D solids in this drawing. Let's create a 3D solid and see the difference. I'll make a box using the box command, pick the first corner, opposite corner, as well as the height of the box. Now I'll click on Optimize again. Now you can choose between 2D and 3D modes because we have 2D and 3D entities in this drawing. I'll erase the solid. Click on Optimize again. You can select entities to be optimized using Select Entities in a Drawing option or by using Entire Drawing option. Since the entire drawing is selected, all the non-frozen entities in the drawing is selected. Using the Select Entities option, you can choose entities to be optimized using the selection methods. When the Close Gap option is selected, the gaps between the line and arc segments will get closed. In the command panel, we have three options for the reference angle: horizontal, vertical, and diagonal. Horizontal and vertical correct near horizontal and vertical lines according to the angle tolerance. Angle tolerance is set over here. The diagonal correct near 45 degree lines to 45 degrees. The distance tolerance sets a distance tolerance value. Parallel lines within this distance will be merged. In this figure, distance tolerance is applicable to this area. So let's find out the distance between these two lines. I'll cancel optimize and I'll pick these two lines, and you can see that the distance is 0.55. I'll go to optimize. The present value of distance tolerance is 0.5. I have to give a value above 0.55 cm. I'll give, say, 1 cm. In gap tolerance, the gap between the entities within this tolerance will be filled. In this figure, gap tolerance is applicable to this area. Let's find out this gap. I'll pick these two lines and you can see that it is 0.39. So I have to give a value which is above 0.39. I'll give the value 1 as the gap tolerance. At the feedback area in the command panel, you will get some information such as highlighted entities will be optimized. That means the entities shown in blue color is going to be optimized and 7 entities are identified. When you click on preview button, it will apply all the settings and you can see the result. Here you can see that these lines are perfectly horizontal and vertical and also at 45 degree angle. The parallel lines which we had over here is collinear and the gap at the corner is no longer existing. If you click on reset, it will cancel all the settings and the entities will go back to the previous state. The keep selection option will cancel the command without optimizing but will keep the highlighted entities, and you can use this selection to perform some other editing command. I'll execute optimize again. Under the tolerances, we have a round off precision option. The dimensions of entities after optimizing will be rounded off to the closest multiple of the round off precision. Presently, the value is 1. I'll give OK. And when I take the cursor onto this entity, you can see that the length of the entity is 22 cm. And the length of this entity is 11 cm. Execute optimize again. I'll change the precision from 1 to 0.1. And I'll give OK. The length of this entity is 21.7, which was 22 before. And length of this entity is 11.4, which was 11 before. That is because you have specified a round off precision of 0.1 centimeter. Likewise, using the round off precision, you can round off the dimensional value of the entities while optimizing. This completes the tutorial on Optimize 2D in BricsCAD V22.